Good morning, and a very, very warm welcome to each and every one of you to our Empowering Morning Conversations. And today's session number 55, and today's topic is Living Powerfully. Now, you can be assured that this is not a lecture session. This is not a Gyan session. We've got every one of you people is a Gyani person, so we don't want to give you any more Gyan. We will have a conversation, however, where we look at what is living powerfully. And as I can see on the screen, we've got a lot of very powerful people here already. So Kuldeep ji, why don't we start with your share? That's a good start to a day anyway.
Good morning, friends.
Morning.
As desired, मैं चार लाइनें पेश करता हूँ आपकी सेवा में कि जिंदगी की अहम बातों में एक बात है ये भी, ये पता करना कि क्या मैं खुश हूँ और यदि नहीं तो क्यों नहीं।
All right, thank you very much. तो वही तो हम कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे। थैंक यू सो मच, सो अप्रोप्रिएट। कुलदीप जी ये बताएं, ऑल द शेरो शायरी बिगैन व्हेन यू वर इन द इंडियन नेवी एंड इन यू नो कमांडिंग योर शिप और व्हाटएवर इट इज दैट यू यूज्ड टू डू
व्हेन आई वाज
लॉन्ग वॉयजेस
व्हेन आई वाज स्टडीइंग इन लखनऊ यूनिवर्सिटी।
अरे बाप रे, इट स्टार्टेड एज फार बैक एज दैट, इज इट
75 ऑनवर्ड्स।
थैंक यू सो मच।
71 ऑनवर्ड्स।
ऑलराइट, सो बिफोर वी एक्चुअली यू नो एक्चुअली वी आर इन इट, so I want to hear from some of you, what do you think? What does it mean for you to live powerfully? So you can unmute yourself and share whatever you think about. What do you think about living powerfully? And are we living powerfully? Sharadji, thank you.
Well, two, three things from my side. One, for me, living powerfully is being able to do what you think is right. Being able to do it when you want to do it, how you want to do it, and actually getting the right objective or the result out of it. Are we living powerfully? Partly yes, partly no. Many things we want to do, we cannot do. Many things that we aim to achieve through a process, we are unable to achieve. I don't want to get into the reasons why that is there. I mean, that is a very debatable thing. But that's about it.
All right. Thank you. You hit the nail on the head. You know, I realized at the age of 27 that I never lived my life by my own choice, you know. And I used to feel very restless and rebellious. It's only later I realized that I was thinking and feeling like that because I was never able to make a choice about my own life. So if you listen carefully to what Sharadji said, you know, when you can live by your choices, for him and for a lot of us, I think that's living powerfully. Thank you so much for your contribution to this conversation. And Neeti, would you like to add something?
So I would say making the choice is one part of it, and achieving what you choose to do is the difficult part, the challenging part, and if we can do that, then I can do it powerfully.
Okay.
Not making compromises there.
All right. So until you achieve it, you may get a feeling that I'm not being powerful?
Yes. Achieving is very important. Yes.
And what if you kept going and never got stopped? Would that not be being powerful?
See, achieving may not be, you know, like a wholesome object that comes in one go. It could be step-wise staggering or, you know, stage by stage. That is okay. But as long as there is an advancement towards your goal, as long as you're making progress, and as long as you're seeing the change and the accomplishments that you set out to achieve.
Right. So yeah. From that definition, Neeti ji, you're one of the most powerful women I know, because you never gave up.
Yes.
And you,
in a way. No,
seriously, you stuck to your principles. You know, you could have taken an easy way out, like many people do. यू चोज द टफ पाथ, यू नो, सो यू आर लाइक गांधी जी, ही सेड आजादी भी लेनी है और खून खराबा भी नहीं होना चाहिए. That was the tough part, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's very interesting, you know, when you live by your choices, you may have lived by your choices or you might have lived by your decisions, I don't know. You know, but the tough part is to make a choice. You know, so when you make a decision, you do your pros and your cons and you minimize your risk and, you know, due diligence, blah, 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 right? Is that powerful or is it more powerful to have the guts to make a choice and say, all right, I'll take the good with the bad, but I choose to live my life this way?
No, I think even when you're taking a decision, there is a good share of choice in it, because a decision cannot be independent of your true self.
Well, that's a good way of looking at it. Thank you very much. Actually, you got me thinking.
Otherwise, the decision will not hold long. You won't go far with it.
You might give up. I mean, I'm
that's
actually
my understanding.
Thinking experientially by, you know, being a part of your journey. So I, you know, I've been observing and listening to you and all that. So you've actually done that, you know.
Yeah, I've done that.
From experience, and I have a lot of regard for that.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. Who's next? Raghu, Karu, nice to see you. Kasa, nice to see you. How are things?
Good, sir. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
A little more develop on it and then I will talk, sir.
What?
I will a little more think of it and then I will discuss.
Yeah, sure. Take your time. You can talk whenever you feel like. There's no compulsion here. All right, who's next? Let's warm a little bit so that you get involved into the topic, you know, and then maybe I'll add a little bit.
Sir, may I share?
Yes, certainly, sir.
Firstly, I totally vouch what Mr. Sharad has said and what Madam Nithi has said. But I just want to add on that besides achieving whatever we want to achieve, journey is equally important. Journey should be stress-free. And I differ from that point that people have said many times, many, many outstanding literary work has been done when people are very sad and all that. It is not that. I feel that it is a inability to differentiate between sadness and the pressure of circumstances. Pressure of circumstances is something different which may not be in our control. But being sad or being not being sad, being stress-free or stressful is always in our control. So journey also should be given equal importance.
Right. And so just to remind everybody, and I'm sure Chaturvedi ji, you also remember, every day I say the same thing and I'm going to say it again. Every experience
yes.
is an opportunity to become a better version of yourself.
Yes, sir.
So would they, in that case, would anything make you feel stressed?
No.
If we are embracing everything and say, chalo, aa jao, you know. You are a gift of God. Every experience is a gift of God, I believe. And I receive it with grace. You know, I honor what comes to me and I learn what I can. And it makes me a better version of myself.
Yeah.
And the more I'm resisting it and the more I'm fighting against it, it just makes me lose what's available in that particular experience, right? And it gives me a lot of stress also. So what Chaturvedi ji says is so true, that if we embrace the journey and live life fully. So living life fully means what? Each and every moment I embrace, I allow myself to experience it, whether I like it or not. And that, my dear friends, is my definition of living powerfully. Because if that happens, anything that life throws at me, you know, is not going to make me weak or powerless. You know, so you can do a bhangra when you are sad and you can do a bhangra when you are happy also. Interesting, isn't it? Thank you so much for sharing. Narayanan ji, would you like to add something to the conversation? Thank you for coming. Thank you for honoring Suresh by being there. He holds you in such high regard.
Actually, the purpose of life, which we have to understood. See, if you see, there was a story during Rama's period. a dog game and barked before the courtyard of Rama. Rama instructed the soldier to find it out. That soldier was make it run away. But it was go on repeating again and again and again. So Rama sent Lakshmana to find out what is the reason for it. Then Lakshmana just patted him and he influenced that he wants to say, the dog wants to say something, communicate to say something. So he went and told Rama that dog wants to communicate something which I am not able to understand. Then Rama went there and again he gathered that one sannyasi has thrown stone and beaten him. So Rama called that sannyasi and asked him, why you have beaten this dog? Then the sannyasi told, I begged my food. When I am going to take, it came and eat. So I thrown stone and hit it. Then Rama explained to him, the dog and other animals are with only fifth sense. It cannot know whatever is available. We should not take without permission. If it is hungry, it will come and take. Whereas the humans are provided with sixth sense. They can hold hunger and they can feed if the dog is hungry. You are also hungry. I never deny that. But you are having a sixth sense to only to analyze why these things are happening. So if you analyze the things happening to your journey, so I, as my master used to say, see, in your life, you have to cross all the 5 points of the Hridaya. If you once crosses that 5 points, you will get to a liberation. And of what? Liberation of everything. Liberation of your looking, liberation of everything. Then what is happening? You have started accepting everything as it is and find the reason for it. It may be come to you to undergo bhog of your samskaras so far you have created.
Absolutely. So and if you live like that.
Yes. We have to practice every, only by practice.
Absolutely. So if you live by awareness,
yes,
and like you're saying, then you will know that every experience is an opportunity to become a better version of yourself. So it's a very profound thing, Mr. Narayanan has said. You know, you can choose using your brains what is appropriate rather than reacting like an animal. See, the difference between us is what? The animal can only react, no? It has only fight and flight behavior. Now we've got another one. It's called the analyzer, brain number two, which is that judging right and wrong, good and bad, and always judging, automatically assuming danger when it's not there, and then again reacting. So one of the sessions I'm going to do this, you know, maybe explain to you. Many of you have been in the Good to Great program, so you understand what I mean by brain number one, two, and three. Others can understand it if you join us on the Good to Great program, whenever you do. Okay? But very profound. Thank you so much for your contribution. So let's move on to the topic for the day. It's exactly on the same lines. And before we move on to the topic of the day, as usual, we will explain to you what is the purpose of the morning conversations. So I will ask Vitrivel to explain our point of view about this.
Good morning, sir. Morning. Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. Thank you very much for this opportunity. In fact, I would say we all are born with this gift of living a life of ease, joy, and glory, and having the same mindset of allowing everything to come to us, ease, joy, and glory. But only problem is, because of our own subconscious behavior and living life, we forgot it. So here, a group of like-minded people, by the guidance of Sukhdeepak, we are trying to unleash that block and trying to make people to understand we have born with the ability to live life with ease, joy and glory, and we can have a life of which comes to everybody with ease, joy and glory. That is what we are trying to do, that sir. Thank you very much.
Yeah, and just to add a little bit to it, in the sea of negativity that surrounds us, you're like, we're getting bombarded all the time. Negative, 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 negative on the news, negative on the TV, right? You talk to anyone, mostly negative. Oh, mera business mein ho gaya, iska COVID ho gaya. Look, it's very sad, okay? A lot of people, you know, in my whole life, I've never lost so many dear friends and relatives than I have in this last 2 years. But that's the reality, right? We can keep on getting influenced by that and we become negative. Our immunity goes down and we also fall sick. We'll be of no use to anyone, no? So the reason for starting this Empowering Morning Conversations 55 sessions ago was that we generate positivity. Because when we generate positivity, we are not allowing the world to influence us. We are influencing the world with our positivity. So it's like when we throw a stone in the pond, the ripples go out. Here, when we become positive, the ripples of positivity go out. And what goes out comes back, always. So sometimes people ask me, why are you doing this, Deepak? Free mein kyun kar rahe? Because I'm very selfish. How it is selfish? Because this world is my world. No, I live in it. This house is my house. I live in it. You are my people, I live with you. So if there is unhappiness all around, does it not affect me? If there's fear all around, does it not affect me? Is it negativity is there all around? Doesn't it affect me? So I'm very selfish. But I want to impact all that so that I can also be happy along with everybody else. A lot of people think, main to khush hoon. Dusre hai ki nahi, mujhe kya lena dena hai. But that's not true. You know that very well. You know, one of the sessions, if you remember, we were talking about who are you excluding from your life. And many of you must have realized that because of your judgments and whatever that we do, we have excluded everybody from our life. So, kaun bach kya gaya? And then you feel ke main akela hoon duniya mein. So anyway, just to remind you, this is about being positive. And when the world is positive, you can imagine what kind of a world will it be. Then you don't have to sing like songs like na mujhe leke chalo aisi gagan ke tale jahan gham bhi na ho aansu bhi na ho. To aise cheezon ke armaan dekhne se acha hai so just wishing it, no, let's do something about it. And thank you very much, the fact that you are here, and every morning, you know, this group is becoming bigger and bigger, and you are inviting your friends also. It says that we are committed. We actually want to do something about it. In this India or the world today, there's no shortage of people who will tell you how things should become better and complaining and this and that. Main bolta hu yaar kuch to kar lo na fir. Do something about it. So thank you guys for joining us all to do something about it. We have lots of people who are doing many things, huh, by the way. This is not the only thing. I mean, if you talk to Sharad, he's doing many things. If you talk to Suresh, he's doing many things. Everybody is doing. So here we are doing some more. So thank you for being with us. So now let's look at a few things which I put together. Because I've been inquiring into this phenomena called living life powerfully. I've been doing it since 1982. Okay. So one thing which I discovered for myself, living powerfully doesn't mean that I'm leading an easy life. So if I'm not going out of the house for fear of getting hurt, that's not certainly living powerfully. If I'm thinking like everybody else, you know, there's some people who agree with everybody. Ah, ye bhi theek hai, ye bhi theek hai, ye bhi theek hai. So in your heart, you feel something is right, but you don't say it because you're afraid that if you say something which disagrees with what somebody else is saying, what is he going to think about me? He will not like me and all that stuff. Is that living life powerfully? I'm telling you, for my life, I used to be like that. If I do something which will upset my father, no, I can't do that. You know, I wouldn't even ask him a question. So when we were in college, I think we were in the second year or something, IMM Ahmedabad had opened and they were about to, you know, admit people. So one of my hostel mates who told me, you know, IMM, I'm going to do MBA and all that. Now, I didn't know anything about what's an MBA. I said, what is MBA? He says, Master of Business Administration. So what's my first reaction? Oh, in our family, nobody's done business. Okay. What am I hearing? I'm not hearing a possibility. What am I hearing? Nobody has done business, so this is not for me. But still, I said, let me ask my dad. You know, now dad was a serving colonel in the Indian Army. I said, Dad, this MBA has come and some people say it's good. Maybe I should do it. He said, leave it. Has anybody done business in our family? So there also, there wasn't even a curiosity to find out, okay, what is this? What kind of a potential will be there? You know, because at that time, there was only one place you could do your MBA. There was no MBA as such. You know, the DCM group, they had this management trainee program. That was the only thing that was available at that time. Initially, one IMM was there and this was there and a couple of things. Nobody knew, really. So is it living life powerfully that you are not even willing to be curious about something which you don't know about? See, there are a lot of people, it is uncomfortable. Arey, yaar, ye technology, who's going to understand it? Yaar? I can't understand it. Better tell me how to do it. So I keep telling them, do it yourself. But I don't know how to do it. So learn it. How does a kid learn? Yeah? So when you are not even making an attempt to do something, is that living life powerfully? Somebody tells you one day, yaar, without preparation, you say something extempore. A lot of people say, yaar, Sukhdeepak tells us to share, you know. Mai to prepare karke nahi aaya. Are yaar, to kya ho gaya? When we were children, we had to prepare before going and say, hello, how are you? No, na. But just see, if I'm limiting myself in any way, am I living my life powerfully? So it's interesting, we would have mastered many things in this universe. Okay? Now, recently I discovered that Sukhdeepak Malvai, you know nothing about investment and stocks and shares and cryptocurrency, and you've been avoiding all your life. You don't even want to listen to anybody who talks. My immediate thought frame is, mere bas ki nahi, I cannot understand. So I enrolled for a 9-month course to learn it. Right? Living powerfully means if you don't know something, find out, no? Now, Neeti ji gave a very nice definition of power this morning. Okay? And I'm remembering that, so I'm sharing it with you because a lot of people actually believe that to be true. And maybe it's true. Kya malum? Right? So power is the rate at which you convert your vision to reality. So hum abhi guzarish karenge jin logon ke Hindi ki gyan bahut acha hai. Every day we are asking Chaturvedi ji or Nidhi ji. Today I'm going to ask Sharad ji to do the translation. Sharad ji, are you there? I'm sure he's there. At least his machine is there. Sharad ji?
I'm absolutely here, sir. I just put the video off for so that their voice is easy to understand. I can easily translate, sir. Most welcome, please.
Thank you so much. So would you do that for us?
Sure, why not?
A new voice. Pleasure. The rate at which you convert your vision to reality.
Just give me a minute, huh? I mean, like,
yeah,
30
yeah, sure,
seconds.
Take your time, yeah. Mr. Sharad is a very, very extraordinary human being. One day he will introduce himself to you and you'll say, oh, aap ye karte ho.
ताकत वो चीज है जो आप किस रफ्तार से अपनी सोच को हकीकत में बदलते हो.
हाँ, ताकत वो है. ताकत एक मेजर है शायद. किस चीज का मेजर है? जिस रफ्तार से आप अपनी कल्पना को साकार करते हो.
राइट.
दैट बी ओके.
यप.
बिकॉज विजन एक आप कल्पना करते हो. जैसे गांधी जी ने बोला था, वन डे इंडिया विल बी फ्री और व्हाटएवर इट इज. एक कल्पना की उसने और सारी योजनाएं की जिससे कि उसको साकार कर पाए.
Right.
और किसी चीज से वो रुके नहीं और हमें रुकने भी नहीं दिया. That is power, right?
Absolutely.
So, to greater or lesser degrees, I think we all have managed to fulfill. But it's interesting. Many people don't even exercise their power to create a vision. They live a bhedchal vision. I remember when we were in college, everybody was either going for medical. Medical nahi mila, so everybody is going for engineering. Or engineering nahi mila, so we are going for chartered accountant. And even if they went for engineering, they all wanted to go for civil engineering. Phir baad mein pata laga, usme scope nahi hai. So do you notice that even people's vision for their life was decided by the circumstances? They're looking at circumstances to find out ki kya cheez sambhav hai, what is possible for me in my life. They're not looking at, hey, I want to do that in my life and how do I make it happen? I can say because I was also like that. Yeah. Till 1982, when I was already having a very good job in an MNC, I never dared to first make a vision ki mujhe wahan pahunchna hai, and then find out how to make it happen. Are you getting what I'm saying, guys?
So, but sir, reason bhi tha na. There was a reason also. There were not too many people, I mean, awareness nahi thi, options nahi the. आज हम डिसाइड कर सकते हैं कि हमको पढ़ना ही नहीं है और फिर भी हम बहुत सक्सेसफुल हो सकते हैं. उस जमाने में नॉन-बिजनेस फैमिलीज में वो चीज नहीं थी.
आई एग्री विद यू शरद जी, मैं उसकी बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ. आप देखें, हम परिस्थिति को देख के डिसाइड कर रहे थे हम क्या कर सकते हैं या नहीं कर सकते. करेक्ट. तो आप कह रहे हो ऑप्शंस कम थे तो हमारे पास चॉइसेस कम थी, ये मैं मानता हूं. बट उस टाइम में भी कुछ लोग थे जिन्होंने कहा, just let's go back in time a little bit, okay? जिन्होंने एरोप्लेन बनाया, they were cycle mechanics. So were they looking at क्या संभव है, and then deciding by looking at the circumstances. They first decided ये तो हमने करना है, and they made it happen. I call them powerful. There was a guy called Roger Bannister. He said, I will run 1 mile in less than 3 minutes. Had it been ever done in the world before? हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं, अरे किसी और ने किया है, पॉसिबल है क्या? अगर किसी ने नहीं किया तो हमको कैसे कर सकते हैं? But there are people who said, hey, I am going to do it. I don't care whether it's possible or not. In fact, doctors told that guy, नहीं हो सकता. अरे फिजिकल बॉडी बनी नहीं है, योर बॉडी इज नॉट केपेबल ऑफ रनिंग सो फास्ट. ही जस्ट डिड इट. एंड व्हेन ही ब्रोक दैट बैरियर दैट ईयर, 3 अदर पीपल डिड इट. And now I think 60-70 people have done it. Why? Because one fellow made a choice. He was not looking at the circumstances. Usne paristhitiyon ko nahi dekha apna vision banane ke liye. So Sharad ji is very right. Hum jab young the, there were very few choices. Ya to bank mein chale jao, bank officer ban jao. I was also sent to Punjab and Sindh Bank chairman. He was very close friend of our family. कहते काका केश रखने पहनगे, मैं कहा वो तो मैं नहीं रखूंगा. देयरफॉर दैट चॉइस वाज नॉट देयर फॉर मी. सो वन, सो आई एम स्टार्टिंग विद वन थिंग, रेट एट विच यू कन्वर्ट योर विजन इनटू रियलिटी. सो डू यू डेयर टू हैव अ विजन विच इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम यू नो एवरीबॉडी एल्स, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, इफ इट इज नॉट विजिबल टू यू इन द एनवायरमेंट, देन विड यू बी एबल टू मेक अ विजन? अगर हम देखते हैं कि हमारे पास क्या चॉइसेस हैं अवेलेबल, तो गांधी जी कभी नहीं बोलते कि भैया हमारा देश आजाद हो जाएगा एक दिन. बिकॉज लॉट ऑफ एविडेंस एंड बिलीफ वॉज देयर कि भाई हम इन अंग्रेजों को कभी नहीं हरा सकते और फलाना एंड ढिमकाना. सो शरद जी इज मेड अ वेरी पावरफुल पॉइंट. चॉइसेस कम थी. एंड डू यू नोटिस वन थिंग, इवन व्हेन वी वर एक्सरसाइजिंग दैट चॉइस आउट ऑफ दोस 4-5 चॉइसेस, we would tend to do something which everybody else was doing. अगर ज्यादा लोग इंजीनियर बनना चाहते हैं तो हम बोलते हैं यार उसमें स्कोप ज्यादा है, वो बन जाते हैं. Am I right or wrong? शरद जी
सर, बहुत सारी चीजें हैं, फैक्टर्स जो मेरी समझ में आते हैं. एक कि उस जमाने में चॉइसेस ऑप्शंस तो खैर कम थे, which we all agree. दूसरी चीज हुआ करती थी कि सर
there's some disturbance, we could not hear you. Just mute and unmute. There's some problem over there. I mean, you can join back after some time. Just mute yourself. Chalo, he can rejoin the conversation at some point. Just let him mute for a while. So just think what I'm saying. See, I'm not asking the reasons why. Okay? There are always reasons. So we're not getting into the reasons right now. All I'm saying is it needs some power to make a choice, which is your own choice. If somebody is unmuted, Nidhi, can you take care of that, please? Thank you. So think, being powerful, the rate at which you convert your vision to reality. Even to have a vision, we need some power, no? Because so many times we're afraid, oh no, no, that is too big for me. How can I start my own company? I have always been an employee, even though I am heading this business. You know, I'm running the business for my investors. Uska dam hai mere paas. So why don't you do it on your own? No, no, no. I don't know if I can do it. So a lot of examples. So starting point, rate at which you convert your vision to reality. And Sharad ji was answering the second question, which is, what stops you? See, if you are not having a vision, if you cannot actualize your vision, if you are not able to first take the first step, pehla kadam hi nahi le paate. And then having taken the first step, to keep going. So all of you are senior people, very accomplished people, you know that very well, that if you try to go for something big or small, obstacles will always be there. Right? So powerful person is the one who says, yeah, I know, obstacles will be there. I will find a way to overcome them. And for that, you need something. So let's look at what that is. So just get a sense in your own life today, because this is a practical session. We are not doing theory here. If you look at your life today, okay, are you experiencing that you're living your life powerfully? That you're living by choice? Like Sharadji very nicely explained in the beginning that, you know, power means that I can do what I want to do. Power means I don't get stopped by the situations, etc., etc. So if you look at your life today, what you want is your choice, right? What vision you want, again, your choice. So some people may want very simple things. Sir, all I want is a little bit of respect, sir. All I want is a little bit of love, sir. That's also a valid choice, no? But even for that, you can be like a victim and say, but they are not giving me respect. But they are not giving me love. There, are you being powerful or are you being weak? I am doing everything, they are not doing. So when we are living in the blame mode, are we being powerful? So somebody is again unmuted. Please mute them. So when we are living in the blaming mode, are we being powerful? When we are living in the complaining mode, are we being powerful? When we are giving up on our ambitions and goals, are we being powerful? When we should speak up and we are not speaking up. Example, agar maine inse kuch pooch liya to wo naraaz ho jayenge. Is that powerful? So just look and see, where are we stopping ourselves? Because that's when the next part of the conversation becomes relevant. Because I really want that, you know, when every morning we meet together, we take away something from here, which will actually add practical value to our life. So that today I will implement something that will make my life different. So the first thing is, whatever you say that you want, are you committed for it? So you say ki main to sukhi hona chahta hu. Are you committed to that? So what's the difference between a want and a commitment? Anybody would like to say? Ek ichha mein aur ek commitment mein.
Right, sir.
Go ahead.
When we have just want, we have intention to do something. But when we are committed, we don't have any excuses. We break everything coming in between. So if
that's what we do. Correct. But my question is, what's the difference between a want and a commitment?
Sir, can I share on a little lighter note?
Yes, yes. Bring the lights.
Whatever I want is my want. Whatever my wife want is a commitment.
Hello, hello. That's a real funny one. Yeah, because she'll make sure that she makes it happen. Danda daayega tumko. Khana nahi milega tumko. Aur bhi bahut cheez nahi milega. Yeah, what's the difference between a want and a commitment?
Yeah, want is what you are really looking for. Commitment really? Is what you are taking actions consistently towards that goal and working out is commitment.
Okay, very good. Then let's expand a little. There's more to it.
Hello.
Yes, yes, go ahead. Abhinav, tum aa gaye ho?
Yes, sir.
Very nice.
Sir,
अब तो तुम्हारी आवाज से हम पहचानने लग गए.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Sir, want is just the goal that you have decided to be there. And when we talk about commitment, the planning and the implementation part is included in that.
Okay, very good. But do you notice the fundamental changes? Want is परिस्थितियां दे देंगे तो मिल जाएगा.
Yes.
Commitment is एक बोल दिया तो बोल दिया फिर उसके बाद मैं अपनी भी नहीं सुनता हूँ. That is commitment.
Definitely.
So when we are committed, we'll make sure. I mean, it's like do or die, you know. And all of us, I can promise you, each and every one of you, at least once or twice in your life, has done this. बोल दिया ये तो करना ही है. Come hell, high water, whatever it might be, this is something I'm committed to. I'm going to have it. Okay, and it will make you face any obstacle that is coming. I committed myself in 1982 to a world that works for everybody, and I haven't stopped. Okay, I've had my big share of problems and obstacles and every damn thing you can expect. Yeah, please go ahead. Haseena ji, go ahead. Thank you, Nidhi.
I give no excuse to myself. I want to cross any hurdle that comes my way. Beyond.
That's commitment.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you so much. So I think we all now understand what's commitment. So whatever it is that you're dealing in your life, okay? Jo bhi paristhiti hai jisse aap jhoonj rahe ho, if you're only complaining, you know, and feeling sad, and all that. One question to ask ourselves is, okay, what am I committed to? And what do I want to do about it? Even the act of communicating, you know, to the other person, hello, this is what I want. That is the first step.
I want to share one small...
Definitely, Suresh.
Yeah. Wish is that what you are thinking of this group. I mean, and commitment is daily we are having sessions.
Exactly.
So whoever comes, whoever not come, we are not bothered. Whoever is coming, okay, fine, they will be benefiting. But regular happening these sessions is a commitment that working, moving towards that, whatever is our wish.
Yeah, very nice. Only one thing I don't agree with it.
Yeah.
Like you said, we don't care if they don't come.
No, no, we care. I mean, the thing will not stop. Whether they...
Yeah, we will do.
Yeah, yeah.
Even if one person comes, we will do.
Yes, yes.
That is commitment.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
Beautiful. Thank you very much for explaining. And once again, I want to thank you, acknowledge you, appreciate you for inviting your friends and family. Because the more you invite, the more the chances of spreading the positivity in this world. Thank you so much for doing that. That's commitment also. See, you have a commitment for their life. That's why you're inviting them, isn't it?
That is true.
Yeah, anybody, and Raghu, I think you wanted to say something.
Yes. Good morning, sir, and good morning, everyone. Commitment is a natural internal force. You will react to it. Wanted, the external force, you will react to it.
A lot of people ask me, how do I know I'm committed? So I say, yeah, look at your results. You'll find out what are you committed to. Your commitment is always reflected out in the world. You know, the world is a mirror of you. So the first thing is commitment. Interesting, isn't it? So whatever it is that you're dealing with in your life, you want to be powerful, get clear. Are you willing to commit yourself to having it? And the second one is, don't give up. Tell me one thing, when will a person not give up? Whatever may happen, he won't give up.
When he is not committed.
He will not give up. When will he not give up, I'm saying?
When he is committed, sir.
When he is committed. So I say, you started your actions when you are committed. You would have not started it only if you were not committed. But have you noticed that many times situations will be so bad that your mind will say, chhod do, not possible. But there are some people who will not give up even then. Why?
Sir, it's the inner voice that keeps you going. If you listen to your inner conscience, your inner conscience.
Yeah, what does it say?
It gives you some indication, something like, you know, ho jayega, keep going, abhi nahi.
That is the one.
You know, maybe 3-4 days of break, but then again, the same vigor will come back.
Exactly. That's what you need to keep saying, ho jayega. Mm. See, you can be persistent if you don't and not give up. As long as you know and you say, hello, this is going to be. Ye toh hona hi hai. Main chhodunga nahi jab tak nahi hoga. So it requires a lot of belief in yourself and what you believe in. Do I believe in that thing that I'm committed to? Do I really want it? If I do, I'll never give up. You might have seen, it's so easy to give up. Na, kabhi kabhi. मन बोलता है यार छोड़ो क्यों मैं क्या जरूरत है क्यों मैंने ये भसूड़ी पाल रखी है व्हाई कांट आई बी लाइक अदर्स कितने चैन से जी रहे हैं ऐसा लगता है कि बड़े चैन से जी रहे हैं ब्यूटीफुल पॉइंट निधि जी सो परसिस्टेंस इज द नेक्स्ट थिंग डोंट गिव अप एंड लेट मी टेल यू समथिंग देयर इज अ वंडरफुल मैकेनिज्म इन द ह्यूमन माइंड इट्स कॉल्ड द रेटिकुलर एक्टिवेटिंग सिस्टम व्हेन यू डोंट गिव अप इट विल स्टार्ट showing you possibilities. Because ultimately, action follows possibility, right? आपको रास्ता नजर आएगा तभी तो हम action ले लेंगे. अब आप मजबूर हो आपको कुछ नजर नहीं आ रहा है कि क्या किया जाए. मुझे याद है 2010 में या 9 में when my late wife was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer and doctor said इन्होंने 6 महीने जीना है. And my situation was pretty precarious from every side, financially and this and that and everything, right? What would be the first reaction? Abhi main kya karu? You know, despair comes in. So luckily, I practice what I preach. So I sat down and said, all right, now what possibilities are there? What else is possible? What else is possible? And by the end of the day, 10 possibilities showed up. One possibility was actually this guy who came and he gave me a blank check and he said, Malvai sahab, jo bharna hai, bhar lo usme. That was the biggest shock I've ever had in my whole life. क्योंकि उस वक्त मेरी जितनी मान्यता थी, whatever I used to believe about people, you know, कि कोई किसी का नहीं है, तकलीफ में सब दोस्त भी छोड़ के भाग जाते हैं, all that nonsense, it got broken completely. And one fellow, simple because of one statement also, कितने लोग आ जाते हैं? One guy, he called me up for some reason and I, hello, sir, क्या हो गया आपको? I mean, I just said hello, क्या हो गया आपको? मैं कुछ नहीं सर, मैं आपको 20 साल से जानता हूँ, आप तो इतने एनर्जेटिक हो, आज क्या हो गया आपको? फिर मैंने उसको बताया, बिकॉज आई वाज, आई मीन व्हेन यू आर इन डिस्पेयर यू डोंट फील लाइक टेलिंग एनीवन आल्सो ना, कि आया मतलब द ग्रेट सुखदीपक मलवई के साथ भी ऐसे हो सकता है, कितने घमंडी हम लोग, बोलने में शर्म आते हैं, यू नो आई मेस्ड इट अप फाइनेंशियली एंड एवरीथिंग एंड मेरा ये बुरा हाल है, बोलने में शर्म आती है ना. फिर मैंने बोल ही दिया, सर क्यों आप घबरा रहे हो सर, आपके तो इतने जानने वाले हैं. ही सेड कि सर वो आप वो मिस प्रसुन्ना से क्यों नहीं बात कर लेते. प्रसुन्ना हैपन टू बी प्रोफेसर इन लेडी हार्डिंग मेडिकल कॉलेज. टक, आई वाज मेकिंग अ लिस्ट, हर नेम वाज देयर इन द लिस्ट एनीवे. जैसे ही उसने मेरे को बोला हिमांशु ने, मैंने उसको फोन किया. सुरेश नोज दैट गाय वेरी वेल, हिमांशु जैन. वैसे मैंने टक उसको फोन किया एंड शी सेड, अरे सर नो प्रॉब्लम, आई नो दिस पर्सन ओवर देयर, मैं उसको भी फोन करती हूँ, आप वहाँ पे जाओ. राइट, इन द मीन टाइम माय डॉटर इन लॉ ऑल्सो फोन अप एंड शी सेड कि मम्मी को वहाँ पे वो ऑर्थोपेडिक के हेड जानते हैं. या वो सी इफ यू डोंट गिव अप ना, फॉर्चुनेटली आई डिडंट गिव अप. तो व्हेन टफ सिचुएशंस कम, there is a tendency to give up, after all we are human beings, and when tough situation comes we make one big mistake, you know, we don't talk to people. Lot of people know when the problem is there they will go into the shell and not talk to anyone, they will not share the problem with anyone. But please, if you are committed and you get stuck, you want to be persistent, talk to people. There is no shame in admitting that you got stopped. कि संभावना नजर नहीं आ रही है, बताओ क्या करूं. So lot of ideas will come. Even children may give you ideas. You'll be shocked, you know. Yeah, somebody is trying to put something in the chat box. Yeah, Narayanan is saying that. Yeah, a lot of people are like that. I will do it on my own. I'm a strong man.
Sir, one thing, can I share?
Yes, sir.
See, I think because of the acceptability of the given situation and feeling that it is come to you for bhog of your samskaras, you may be allowed to go like that. This is my thinking. I may be wrong.
You are right and wrong, yes. If I may say so. See, if you have that acceptance, like I say, every experience is an opportunity to become a better version of myself. You know, so that means the situation is not bothering you that much.
Not
it is
like
troubling
that.
You. It is no, troubling
it's
you.
It's troubling me like anything. Even I am telling you, my conditions, my things are all different. But one thing has understood that when I am undergoing all these things, I used to remember the King Harichandra story. You know, the King Harichandra, he got realization and saw God. When he accepted everything, he never burbled and he undergo all the difficulties. And his son Logidasa came as a dead body. Even at that time, he was persistent, he was committed to the job which he is doing at that time.
Exactly.
See,
that's the main point.
I don't know whether it is
listen.
Right or wrong.
You are saying right, very right. Now you listen to what I'm saying. Because yeah. I'm saying the same thing.
Yeah.
When you are in allowance of what is happening to you, good or bad, then you will start to see the possibilities. Like you said, Harishchandra saw the possibility.
Yeah.
When you see possibility, then you can take the action which will give you the result that you want. After all, there is some result you want. You are accepting the situation which has blocked you. That's exactly which was happening to me also. Okay. I had no choice, no? If I had resisted that situation, I would have fallen sick. I would have taken some wrong action as a reaction, you know. So I was in that situation, I was accepting it, I was experiencing it, and then I was speaking to people, I started doing certain actions, and I saw some possibilities. Possibility means, okay, what should I do now?
Okay.
There are many things we can do. There's a very famous guy, Dr. Edward de Bono. He's done a lot of research about the human mind, and he's written 19 books about how people use their brains. He says possibilities are always there. Possibility means sambhavana. I don't know in Telugu also if sambhavana means possibility or not. Reddy garu, what is the word for possibility in Telugu?
I think same one, sir.
Sambhavana, no?
Yes, sir.
So when you see the sambhavana, then you can take the action. When you don't see any sambhavana, then you're stuck. And then you might give up. But if you say, I'm not going to give up, I'm not going to be defeated, then the mind will start show you the sambhavanas. Then you can get into the right action. The important thing is right action. So when you are in the resistance mode, when you are in the reaction mode, the chances are you may take some wrong actions. So instead of going forward, you may start going backward also. So that is step number two. Let's look at what step number three might be. This is something which I say, okay, let us keep developing it all our life, you know, an attitude for look for possibilities. I think we've had too much of this heavy discussion. So let's do an exercise. Mitrival, would you kindly lead them into the exercise?
Yes, sir.
Just explain. Many new people are there. They don't know.
Exactly, sir. Thank
what
you
What are the silly things that we do over here?
The moment where they start to do it, they will understand how great thing it is. Anyway, what we do is, we do laughing exercise. Generating silent laughter without making any noise. And it has been proved that you can generate the feeling whichever you want. And when you create this laughing, all your chemicals positive chemicals are being segregated. You will really feel happy. Let's experiment it. Just try 100% laughter when I say 1, 2, 3. Let it go for 1 minute. 1, 2, 3. Come on. Just a quick check. Is it 100%? Is that 100%?
Okay, thank you, Mitrival. See, I'm telling you, this is particularly useful when you are getting stopped and you're feeling despondent and your mind is saying, "Arey, Baba, what should I do now?" And I'll tell you something. When you're in this playful mood, your mind will show you more possibilities. This is proven scientific fact. When your mind is at rest, when the mind is in a playful mood, we learn more, we see more possibilities, we get unstuck from what we are stuck with, and we are more in the present moment also. So commitment, persistence, and the developing of a possibility search attitude. And that's an attitude which enterprising people have. Enterprising people, they see possibilities, where ordinary people see roadblocks and obstacles. Nidhi ji, translation bataye.
Sir, sadharan vyakti zindagi mein mushkile dekhta hai, jabki jo asadharan vyakti hai, wo
सो वी विल डू इट अगेन. इसका थोड़ा सा भाव चेंज हो गया. एंटरप्राइजिंग पीपल सी पॉसिबिलिटीज वेयर ऑर्डिनरी पीपल. अभी आप फिर नहीं सुन रही हो, पहले ट्रांसलेट करना शुरू, फिर से बोलता हूँ. एंटरप्राइजिंग पीपल सी पॉसिबिलिटीज वेयर ऑर्डिनरी पीपल सी रोड ब्लॉक्स एंड ऑब्स्टेकल्स.
असाधारण व्यक्ति जिंदगी में संभावनाएं देखता है, जबकि साधारण व्यक्ति मुश्किलों से मुश्किलों में अटक के रह जाता है.
ये अभी आपने ट्रांसलेशन में थोड़ा ट्रांसलेशन कर दिया. सक्षम लोग संभावनाएं देखते हैं जहां पे साधारण लोग रुकावटें देखते हैं. उन्हीं परिस्थितियों में, इन द सेम सिचुएशन where ordinary people are seeing roadblocks and obstacles, enterprising people, they are seeing possibilities. I could give you 100 examples and we can do a whole session on this. Those long sessions are available to participants of the Good to Great program. So,
I want to share one thing, sir.
You can share two things, sir.
Yeah, like possibilities. In these recent days, you know, coronavirus has, you know, spread all over the world, and the scientists, they have seen, I mean, they do not know what can be the results, but they worked on that virus, and you know, they brought all these medicine. Different people with a different, like someone say Covaxin, Covishield, or some, these are the possibilities. What I mean, even though they do not know what can be the results, but they worked out on that and brought the results.
Yeah, absolutely. You remember the chap called Newton?
Yeah.
He was sitting under the tree and apple fell on his head, and he saw a possibility in that also.
Gravitation power.
Yeah. Ordinary guy would have said, "Arey, apple will fall down only, you know, it won't fall up." But that guy says, "Why does it fall down? What are the principles behind it?" So she started looking at those possibilities, right? Gravitational theory came out of it.
Sometimes
that's the way
vision,
we can all be.
Vision may not be very clear, but if you keep working out on that, some results will come definitely.
Yeah, and I'll tell you one thing. People who are enterprising, they will always do communication to generate possibilities. Okay, self-communication, communication with others. You know, you can have a conversation to kill the possibility, or you can have a conversation which will open up possibilities for everyone. Which one is better?
Open up possibilities is always better, you know, instead of killing.
Exactly.
It helps.
But the way we normally communicate, yeah, that's not what we do, no. That is the reason why for the month of June, the topic for Good to Great is communication. And looking at this very, 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 very powerful tool, which we are only using for transaction. You understand? It's much more than that. It's a tool that can generate. It can generate possibilities. It can give you anything you want in your life, provided you can communicate like that.
Yeah. And even if someone sees, you know, like at present you are in a line in one field. If you see in future, it may go down. Diversification is also,
another possibility.
And like our Mr. Ranjan Chopra.
Yeah, he sees a possibility,
yeah,
gets into action.
Yes, yes.
And he creates something new.
Yeah.
That's called possibility search attitude.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
People who don't have it, they will be stuck in only one thing. Okay.
Yeah.
Which is also okay. Because they can say, okay, I will create a possibility of being a master in this, being the best in it, whatever it is that you wish to do.
Yeah.
All right. So thank you very much, guys. We've given you a little glimpse about living powerfully. Have we done all of it? No. Be with us every session of the Empowering Morning Conversation. Will add something to you so that you can live your life powerfully. And you can live a life you love and have a life of ease, joy and glory and have a positive life and spread positivity to people all around you. We are possibility catalysts. And thank you very much for being a part of the journey. I'm so grateful to all of you that you've joined us this morning. And please keep joining us and spread the message. Thank you very much. Bye, 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 bye.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.